الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا أما بعد إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إن خير الأمور عوازمها وشر الأمور محدثاتها كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسر قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من أيام عمل الصالح أحب إلى الله من الأعمال في أيام العشرة من ذو الحجة أو كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who once again has provided us this opportunity to offer Salatul Jum'ah. And as I always emphasize, when we come to the masjid, we should come with the objective to bring some improvement. Not only to offer rites and rituals, to do our obligatory salah, but to bring some improvement, to know something more about Islam, to know something more about to start doing in our daily lives, to bring improvement in ourselves and in the community at large. Alhamdulillah, now we are entering in one of the blessed months from tomorrow, the month of Dhul-Hijjah, the month in which we have one of the five pillars of Islam, Al-Hajj. I recited Surah Al-Fajr, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sworn by وَلَيَالِ الْعَشْرِ وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. And majority of the scholars, they agree that these layalin ashr is the 10 days or the 10 nights, the first 10 days or 10 nights of the Shahr of Dhul-Hijjah. 9 days up to the Yawmul Arafah and the 10th day of Hajj. And the hadith that I recited, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are no better deeds to be done in these 10 days than any other days in the year. We will not go into this debate or argument whether these 10 days are better than Ramadan or not. In fact, it's a kind of bonus, a kind of opportunities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep giving us again and again, sometime in Ramadan, sometime in the month of Dhul-Hijj, so that we move forward, سَابِقُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, so that we always try to benefit from these days, whether the month of Ramadan or the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. Fasting is also highly recommended by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is not obligatory, but fasting is also recommended. Even if we cannot fast for the first 9 days, at least we should do all our sincere efforts to fast on the 9th day, which is the day of Hajj, which is the day of Yawm al-Arafah. There are many ahadith and many recommendations that if we perform good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will greatly reward us. And when we talk about good deeds, our focus goes only that we should offer nawafil and salah and sadaqah. Even having a smile on our face is a good deed. Even doing some charity is a good deed. Treating fellow Muslims or the public in general with courtesy, with akhlaq, is a good deed. So we should also focus on these kind of good deeds. And not only that you increase your salah and nawafil. It's not that we are undermining the importance of nawafil. What we are trying is to highlight the importance of akhlaq in Islam, something that we have almost forgotten. We think that we have a confirmed entry to Jannah based on our good deeds that we perform in this masjid. Islam is outside this masjid as well. It is not restricted. When we come to this masjid, the purpose, the objective is to learn and to spread the message outside. And this is what this Al-Falah Islamic Center is trying to hold on the 24th of September. That is the main objective. It is not an individual's responsibility. In fact, it is the responsibility of the whole community. The way the mainstream media is mischaracterizing Islam and smearing the name of Muslim Ummah, we need to play our due role. First, we need to ask ourselves, do they really represent Islam? Certainly not. Then why are we not playing our due role? Why are we silent? You know that silence is a crime. Silence is a crime considered in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you see something is happening wrong, you have to get up according to your istita'a, according to your capacity and capabilities. We have to play our role. We have some circle of influence, each and every one of us, no matter where do we live. We have some circle of influence. We need to play that influence in that circle, with our neighbors, with our peers, with our subordinates. It's not something nice to have. It has become a necessity. Wallahi al-Azim, we need to realize that it has become a necessity. The others, they are labeling us. They are trying to defame us. How can we remain silent? We need to come forward and play our due role and tell them the true values of Islam. How we give importance of saying the truth. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida. We need to represent that if we are Muslims, we are always going to tell the truth. We never lie. We never cheat. We always treat our neighbors with kindness. We care for them. If they are in need, we should be the first to help them. This is how we are going to promote Islam. We are not living in a Muslim country so that the people know what Islam is. How are we going to tell them? If somebody asks you, who doesn't know about Islam, a non-Muslim, what is Islam? What are you going to tell him? Islam is about 5 prayers and salah and zakah and fasting. They don't know anything. You have to tell them about the good mannerism in Islam, how we treat the neighbors, how much emphasis has been placed in so many ahadith, so much so that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam once thought that maybe the neighbors would be given some share in the here. So much so. And yet our neighbors, they don't even know about us. Neighbors should be the first to recommend, to certify, to verify that yes, our neighbors, if they are Muslim, they are the best neighbors. And I have quoted this before as well, but it's always good to share that Sayyid Abdullah ibn Mubarak, one of the greatest scholars of Islam, his neighbor was a Jew. And when he was selling his house, he was selling more than the market price. So the people ask him, why you are selling this house at a higher price? There is no ravine, there is no special pool-sized lot, anything. Why you are selling your house at a higher price? He said, because you will get a neighbor like Abdullah ibn Mubarak in this house. Why can't we represent the personality of Abdullah ibn Mubarak? At least to some extent, at least 10%, by caring for our neighbor, by telling the truth, by having a smile on our faces, and so many things. Akhlaqiyat, the characters, the morals are more important. So let's try to focus on these things as well. The nawafil are more important, because when we offer obligatory prayers, it is something that is obligatory upon us. We are not doing a favor. That's why the importance of Salatul Tahajjud is considered the most beloved salah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because it is not obligatory, but still if we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we come forward and we offer that salah at night when the majority of the world is fast asleep. Same is the case. In these 10 days, nothing is obligatory. But if we want to show our love, and if we want to avail the benefit of these 10 days and 10 nights, we need to come forward. The more, the merrier. The more we do, the more it's going to benefit all of us. So please make sure that we try our best to avail the opportunity of these 10 days where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sworn for these 10 days. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing, it is something of really, really great importance. We have seen in the Quran, wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing for something, it has great importance. Similar is the case with these 10 nights and 10 days. It has great importance. Ramadan has its own value and virtues because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Al-Quran al-Kareem in the month of Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The nights and Laylatul Qadr and other benefits. Same is the case with these 10 days also. We have another pillar of Islam. If in Ramadan you have fasting, in these 10 days you have Hajj. Even if we are not performing Hajj, we need to show our relation, show our solidarity with all those who are performing Hajj. It is recommended not to cut your nails or not to cut your hair the way Hujjaj are doing, because they are restricted. So it is also recommended, in order to show your solidarity, you can also do this. These are small things, but in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has great reward and great value. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this understanding, the courage, and the time to discuss this with our family members and to put this into practice. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. Continue with the subject of having influence on the community and playing our due role. When we come to this part of the world, we come initially, most of us, we came with an objective to have a better standard of life. More security, better jobs, and all the worldly benefits, of course. But when we come here, we realize that as a minority, Muslim being in a minority, we have some challenges. So we need to play that role as well. Islam is not at danger. It is the Muslim Ummah who is facing the danger. Islam is protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Since the very inception of this world, the Ummah, the followers, they are always at risk, because when they forget, when they become oblivious of the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they stop following the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are at risk. So individually as well as collectively, we are all facing this risk. We cannot keep ourselves away. We need to play our role. Al-Falah Islamic Center is doing a great work for the community. But as a center, it has no value if we don't come forward and join our hands and play our due role. We are so lucky to have this center where it's not only that we can offer 5 times prayers, we have so many opportunities for the youth. Basketball court and martial arts classes, Quran classes, so many things. Bring your children, bring your families. Because if we do not focus on this, all of a sudden, one day we come to realize that the damage has already been done. Then we look forward, then we look here and there and we ask for the shuyukh and we ask for the... It's already late. We were so much busy to get more and more from this world that we forgot about the world hereafter. بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. There is no harm in focusing on this world, but it should not be at the cost of the world hereafter. Please spare some time, your weekends, fortnights, if not possible every weekend, at least once in 2 weeks. Come to this masjid, come to this Islamic center, bring your families, learn something, and then go forward and spread this message of love, kindness, love of neighbors, love of the people you come into interact with others. This is the message of Islam. How come media is portraying a wrong image about us? Because they look at us. Are we the true representative of Islam? Individually, I would say no, I am not representing. That's why they get this chance to defame. Each and every person can play its due role. As I said earlier, if our neighbors right and left consider all of us, alhamdulillah, 500 or thousands of families, could be 2,000 neighbors, could be 3,000 neighbors. If they come forward and they say, no, Muslims are different because I know my neighbor and he is a different person. He is not what media is portraying. We can play a significant role. We can have a massive impact. We need to be careful. Alhamdulillah, in Canada, it's not the case what is happening in US. But we should not be complacent. We should not be complacent. This is an opportunity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The biggest problem with Muslims, we become complacent because shaitan comes to us and tells us, you don't have to do anything, you are safe. Just because you are Muslim, you have a path, you have a free entry to Jannah. That's not the case. If we are Muslims, munafiqeen are also from Muslims. How can we guarantee, how do we know that we are Muslim but we are not from the category of munafiqeen? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from that category. So that is very important. Don't be complacent. The way we are not complacent in this world, we always try to get more and more. We are never complacent. We want to replace new furniture, new curtains, everything with season. What about the real world? The real world, the everlasting world. That's the reason we come here, to spend some time, to ponder about it, to reflect. And subhanallah, Friday comes before the weekend, so we always get 2 days of holidays. Spend some time. Strengthen your relation with Quran. Try to spread the message, influence others. Don't be influenced. If you increase your circle of influence, you can continuously increase it wider and wider and wider. But if you increase your circle of concern, then others would be influencing you. And this is what is happening. We always carry a sorry face because this is what media is trying, and we become the victim. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising us, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. You don't have to grieve. You don't have to feel sorry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you, and you will be superior and you will be successful if you are the true believers. So what is wrong? Is the message wrong? Is the promise wrong? Or something wrong with us? Of course something wrong with us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he promises, who else can fulfill his promise? وَمَنْ أَصْطَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. So we need to understand this. Instead of carrying a sorry face, instead of becoming apologetic, we need to look into the deeds that we really need to perform. And inshallah, with this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's guidance and support and help is always there. Always there. This is what He has promised. Had we learned Quran, had we understood Quran, we would have known this by ourselves. You don't need khatib, you don't need scholars to tell this. You can have a direct relation with Quran. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that we have made Quran easy. Quran is very easy. For specific issues, for complicated issues, you need to go to shuyukh and scholars and mufti. Otherwise, Quran is easy to understand. Every day we recite Surah Al-Fatiha, we say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. We are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the straight path. How come He is not guiding us? Na'udhu billah, is this a joke? No. We are asking Him, but we are not fulfilling the responsibilities. So, on a serious note, please look into this opportunity given to us by Al-Falah Islamic Center. Communicate the message, bring as many people as you can, develop that relationship with the community, clarify the misconceptions created, be a role model, and become the leaders in this community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أصلح شباب المسلمين اللهم أصلح شباب المسلمين اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم انصر المسلمين في سائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أقيموا الصلاة